like 1952 number one. So it is going to be him.
Okay.
And Roy Lichtenstein was, you know, Wham and the pop art type thing, so it's not going to be him. So my answer is James Whistler.
And the Beatles were one step down on the board. That's moved that $20,000. I don't like it sitting there.
Do you?
No, we had to move it. Okay, next question. What international company sells products with names like Hunta, Ragi, and Sarti? Keurig, Electrolux, or IKEA? Kimmy, do you know this one?
I do, because I live in Manhattan, which means that 90% of my apartment is furnished with IKEA.
Are these brand names found at IKEA?
IKEA is named after Ingvar Kamprad, I think his name is. He has been, up until comparatively recently, at some point the richest man in the world.
Oh. And the Beatles were one step down on the board. Next question, please. Which of these European capitals has not appeared in the title of a recent Woody Allen movie?
Three.
Rome, London, or Paris? Jenny locks in with London. Definitely know it's not Paris. Paris match. So between Rome and London, I'm hoping London. Rome is far more romantic. All right. Does London not appear in a Woody Allen movie title?
And I'm sure I'd have heard of it if you'd use London in the title, so my answer is London.
Thank you, Paul. This is on the board once again. You're doing great, Jenny. Good luck. Here's the next question. Ugandan dictator Idi Amin was once a champion in what sport? Soccer, boxing, or weightlifting? Jenny, what do you think?
Because he was a dictator, I'm hoping it was an aggressive sport, so I'm guessing boxing.
Just a guess,
because I don't think he was a weightlifter, since he didn't look very big, and soccer, he would have to be a team player to be a champion in soccer, so good point.
Good logic.
Okay. Was Idi Amin once a boxing champion?
It's ironic considering the trouble he later caused the British government, but Idi Amin actually served in the British Army, where he was a very fit young man, and he was the British Army light heavyweight boxing champion.
Interesting. Beastie once again follows us down the board.
You're taking 10 grand, you're safe now.
It's okay.
Instead of Richard Gallagher pressure.
We're still safe, I'd like to point out. Thank you very much. $20,000, Jenny, only one more correct answer puts that money in the bank and sends you to the final chase. Next, and hopefully last question, please. As a sign of rank, ancient Egyptian kings and queens typically wore long face what? Beards, eyelashes, or cheetah tails? Jenny, tell me your notes.